The Mom Hour is brought to you by partners like The Essential Calendar. The Essential Calendar makes beautiful, minimalist, poster-sized calendars that show an entire season at a glance so you can see and plan for the big picture. If you're looking ahead to 2024 and have big plans you want to see all in one place, visit theessentialcalendar.com/themomhour. You'll save 10% off your purchase when you visit that link or when you use our code THEMOMHOUR at checkout. Again, that's 10% off our favorite seasonal calendars at theessentialcalendar.com/themomhour.
Hi, I'm Sarah. I'm a mom of three kids, ages 2, 5, and 7, and I live in Southern California.
And I'm Megan. I am the mom of 5 kids, ages 6 through 17, and I live in Michigan. This is The Mom Hour, part of the Life Listened Network. Hey everyone, and welcome to episode 32 of The Mom Hour. I am Megan Francis, here as always with Sarah Powers. Hey Sarah, how are you?
I'm great, Megan. How are you?
I'm good. We are recording on a Monday today rather than a Friday because I had a little personal drama where Owen, my 10-year-old, wound up in the hospital last Thursday.
Oh my gosh.
He has like, I guess what they consider walking pneumonia.
It'd be scary though to end up in the ER.
Yeah. Well, nobody ever likes that. And it was, you know, we got in there and they got under control really fast, but they didn't want to let him go until they could be able to breathe, which I guess is
it's so good that he could tell you what was happening. Cause we've never ended up in the ER, but we've had some close calls with bronchial pneumonia type stuff. And it is really like when you Google it and stuff, it just says, you know, look for the retracted breathing.
And I did that. And he didn't have that.
But like with a baby and toddlers. So it's so glad he was able to come to you and say, what did he say?
Like, he said, I can't get a good breath.
Yeah. I can't breathe. Mom.
And his lips didn't look right. I wouldn't say they were blue, but they just didn't look right. Like he didn't look right. It just was one of those gut things where I was like, nah. And he'd been fighting it for days and it would perk up and then get bad again and perk up. And then I just kind of thought, nah, we're taking him in now. So he's on the mend. Everything's good. He's bouncing off the walls again and very bored. Although he went back to school today, but he was very bored over the weekend. So
well now, and all of a sudden it's December. This will air tomorrow, the 15th, and we are like in 10-day countdown mode to Christmas.
I know. Ah, so today's episode, we're going to talk about what we want and what we think moms want and should and deserve and should get for Christmas. But first,
go ahead. Oh, yeah. Well, here's why I think we need to do this is because does this ever happen to you where you focus on what everybody else wants? I know that cliche, yada, yada. But really, people even will ask me if I have any idea of what I want for Christmas. And I really honestly, it's not that I'm being, you know, like self-deprecating or anything. I just can't think of anything that I want. And then what happens to me is I end up going to the mall last minute because I do most of my shopping online, but I'll do like one quick mall trip by myself, like 4 days before Christmas. And I look around, I'm like, ooh, I want that.
I want all
like,
that.
Ooh, I want that. And then it's too late. It does help to actually like get a little inspiration in time to give some hints. So
and since we know that a lot of dads and partners and kids tend to wait and do that shopping last minute for mom, I think this is actually very timely.
Yeah.
So, and you know, I'm the same way, Sarah, like today, you know, when I asked Sarah, what are we talking about today again? Because I forgot like I always do. And she said, we're talking about what we want for Christmas. And I thought, oh gosh, I don't even know. I haven't even thought about it. Luckily, John's a really good kind of intuitive gift giver, but not everyone is in that position. So yeah. All right. So I'm going to let you take it from the top, Sarah, but we have a little semi-irregular,
more irregular segment.
Yes.
Yeah, let's look at Instagram. So if you're new to this show, every couple weeks we look at each other's Instagram feeds and kind of pick a moment and let you guys into our personal lives via Instagram. You can follow us on Instagram. We'll link to that in the show notes at themomhour.com. But I just pulled up yours, Megan, and the first one that is so cute is a picture of you and Clara having breakfast in bed. And I know breakfast in bed is a staple of your life.
Yeah. I know. I'm spoiled.
So cute.
It is. And she joined me that day. And I don't even really remember why. She just didn't feel real well or something. And she just decided we both needed to have.
Oh, and she has the cutest little bedhead too. She looks younger than she is. I've seen her in person and she's almost 7, but she looks little in this picture. It's really cute.
It's pretty cute.
I love that.
Yeah.
And then, also, you have to talk about Clara's writing that she's been doing lately because you have a few Instagrams of her fictionalized drama, would you call it?
Yeah. Well, she loves to write, and I love that. And she writes these really sort of they're high, it's like high drama stories. So this one, I have to look at it again. It's so funny.
There's, yeah, well, there have been a few lately. Like, I'm now scrolling. So you are at Megan Francis, if anyone wants to head right there.
Remember to go to it with the two A's. Yeah, M-E-A-J-N.
Because it is like, you almost have to like continue the saga of Claire's book to know where you are.
Well, the one I was just was thinking of was what she had just written the cover. She hasn't actually written the story yet. So I'm really eager to see where this one's going to go. It's called The Book of Caitlin and Jack. And then the subtitle is It's Sad, It's Life. She cracks me up, but I don't even know where she gets this stuff from because it's her life is pretty great.
Yeah.
You know, she also wrote one called Party All Night Long, which features a disco ball and like three happy people and one really sad person. And she always has like someone frowning in every picture she ever draws.
Yes. There's been some drawings where there's some very distraught stick figures.
Yeah. Another one I have to mention really quick was she wrote a fan mail to this YouTube star she loves. And the note says, my brothers hate you, but I don't hate you. That's the best she could do for fan mail. I mean, she's just really, really honest, I think. So, my mom doesn't give me treats that often. That was another one. Anyway, I could go on and on, but yeah, check it out. It's very funny. If you want to chuckle at
that is
a clever
great.
Little girl who likes to dramatize things and imagines her life to be much worse.
So cute. And her little printing and writing. And it's amazing how that develops even over like a few months, I feel like.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. So Sarah, I've got two very different ones for you, but the first one, I'm just so impressed that you actually made, a craft with a wine cork.
I did. I have been hoarding wine corks for like 10 years.
I had to throw mine away at one point because it got really embarrassing.
I know. Well, Brian will just look at me sometimes and be like, are we still doing this? Like we're still, and So I made some wine cork snowmen. I Googled crafts. I thought this year, let's just do, because I've looked at like the really pretty front door wreaths before and they're just really overwhelming. I know people who've done them and there's a million ways you can do a pretty wreath with wine corks. And I think I have enough, but it just seemed like such a big project. So these are little ornament snowmen. And the cork, there's one whole cork for the body and then a sliced cork circle for the head. And they're put together with toothpicks. And we had fun. The kids helped. We did it over a couple sessions, but there was hot glue involved and paint.
I'm going to have to do these, I think. Is there a place we can find the craft?
I just Googled even just the images, so I didn't actually look at a step-by-step, but I will put my image in there, and then if I can find a step-by-step, I'll link to it in the show notes. But they're just put together with, maybe I should write up a DIY. Ooh. No, I'm just kidding. with toothpicks. And when you look at the picture, you can kind of see what people have done, but they have little ribbons for scarves and,
they're very cute. I wanted to make an ornament with Clara this year and maybe Owen if he's up for it. So I will definitely check that out because that looks like a lot of fun and I have corks to use. The other picture I wanted to just mention really quick, I mean, I don't know what you have to say about it. It's your typical cute kid picture, but it's Violet all dressed up. She looks like she's going to a garden party or something.
I know.
She's wearing a glove and a purse.
I know. And I don't know if you saw the caption, but I had asked Allegra, who's 7, to get her ready for bed. And that is that's what they came out with. So she's wearing like a fancy dress, a purse, one glove, a hat, and she's got this great.
And she's posing.
Yeah.
She's definitely posing. So adorable.
My 7-year-old is super responsible and normally would take that very seriously and actually get her ready for bed. But I think she was in a spunky mood, which I fully endorse. And they came out and I was like, well, that is not what I expected.
That's funny.
Good times.
Should we dive in?
Yeah, let's do it. So again, we're talking about what we want for Christmas this year, what you listeners may want if you haven't thought about it, and why you should think about it. So when you and I were writing regularly at The Happiest Home, we did a couple of blog posts of this type over the last few Christmases. So I'm kind of going to start with those, and then we can just riff as we do.
We can tangentially riff.
But the first thing I want to bring up, because this is a brand you and I have followed for a long time, and it's a brand that does a lot of social good, is Fashionable.
Say it. I always just say Fashionable.
Yeah. So, but the Ubble is capital A-B-L-E, like caps. And they are kind of like a social good brand that empowers women, mostly in, I think, African countries, who are creating these beautiful pieces. They started with just scarves, but now they have leather goods. And I actually had my eye on one of the bags this year that I will link to from their site, just kind of like an everyday satchel tote type bag. But they did add some leather products in couple years. And you and I both have their scarves. We'll link to them in the show notes. We don't have any affiliation with them, except that it is nice to shop from a brand like that that's doing a lot of good. And their products are just really beautiful. So the scarves, I think, don't you have kind of a lightweight scarf from there?
I have a lighter weight one, yeah. And they make the weight really clear. Sometimes it's hard to shop for those kinds of things online.
Right.
But in the descriptions, they make it really clear what the weight is.
So. Right.
We are welcoming our longtime sponsor, PrepDish, back to the show today. And listeners, if you're looking to boost your protein intake, PrepDish is making it so easy right now. When you sign up in January, you'll get access to a month's worth of the new PrepDish Protein Boost meal plans.
I love this, Sarah. Protein is so important for our health. It helps support mental clarity, sleep, energy, hormone balance, and more. And as busy moms, we're often not getting enough protein, especially at breakfast. With these meal plans from PrepDish, you'll learn how to quickly prep 4 protein-rich dinners and 1 breakfast.
Right. And like all PrepDish meal plans, they make it so simple to shop once, prep for the week ahead of time, and save time on busy weeknights by having your meals ready to heat and serve. And Megan, these meals sound so delicious and perfect for January. Listen to this. Slow cooker carnitas bowls, stuffed pepper soup, and then there's a Swiss chard mushroom and goat cheese frittata for breakfast.
Okay, I am adding that stuffed pepper soup to my rotation ASAP. This is a limited time offer, so make sure to sign up before the end of January to get your free bonus meal plans. To learn more and sign up now, visit prepdish.com/themomhour. Again, that's prepdish.com/themomhour for a month's worth of the new PrepDish Protein Boost meal plans. Check it out. Sarah, you know when someone's trying to sell me something, I can be pretty skeptical. Maybe it's my rebel tendencies, but having some healthy doubts has definitely kept me from wasting money on every cool product the algorithm sends my way. You know what's not too good to be true, though? Our sponsor, Ritual, and their clinically backed Essential for Women 18 Plus multivitamin.
Yeah, Megan, that's so true. We both love these vitamins because they're made with high quality and traceable key ingredients in clean, bioavailable forms. And they're gentle on an empty stomach with a fresh, minty essence in every bottle, so you don't have to worry about nausea if you're a bit relaxed about when you take them. I'm also a big fan of Ritual's sustainability standards. They use scientific tools to select lower carbon packaging, prioritize sustainably sourced ingredients, and set ambitious climate goals.
No more shady business. Ritual's Essential for Women 18 Plus is a multivitamin you can actually trust. Get 20% off your first month for a limited time at ritual.com/themomhour. Start Ritual or add Essential for Women 18 Plus to your subscription today. That's ritual.com/themomhour for 20% off.
Yeah. So if you're like me and you're living in Michigan and it's like 60 degrees in the middle of December, you may not be ready for a wool scarf yet.
I bring that up because I know we talk about the weather sometimes, but I think you and I have like flip weather today. It's freezing here and windy. Like, yeah. So
I don't think we're going to have any snow before Christmas. So, you know, and usually I'd be bummed about that, but it's been so, the last couple winters have been so crazy. I don't really care. It's fine.
Yeah. I hear you. And we enjoy it here because we don't always get it. So it's really blustery and cold here. That website is livefashionable.com. So L-I-V-E fashionable.com. And they've just added so many products and it's just beautiful. So if you have something on your wish list that's kind of, you know, scarf, handbag, necklace, they have some jewelry now. Check it out because why not also, you know, support an organization that's doing a lot of good at the same time. So they have a cool story. So that's just where I wanted to start.
Absolutely.
Do you have any sort of like fashion things on your wish list this year? Does John get you that kind of stuff or is that more of a personal shop for yourself?
It tends to be more of a personal thing. Will get me things like. One thing I would really love this year and was sort of a staple that he was getting me every year for a while. Well, he used to always get me a nice bathrobe and I love bathrobes, but then I thought, you know, my lifestyle really more lends itself toward cardigans because I don't like to walk around the bathtub. In a bathrobe. I just don't feel like I'm put together then, but I want to be comfy and cozy in my house. So.
And do you have I have like a serious bathrobe problem with sleeves. I don't like that the sleeves.
And they drag in your food and stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. And,
yes.
And, in the sink. Like I'm always washing my hands or doing dishes at the sink. So I feel like they don't stay up. I need like something I can push up the sleeves.
Yeah. I just need something and a little more streamlined, like something that I could, like, I feel like I'm dressed even if I'm not. So, we started going for him getting me, cardigans, and not every year because usually the cardigan will last longer than a year. I don't wear it, you know, wear it out. But this year I am up for a new cardigan. So if anybody has any, you know, any, recommendations of a cardigan that's awesomely soft and warm and bulky and big and maybe has a tie so it's not just flapping open all like the time.
I think you called it a house sweater before.
Yeah, like a house sweater. Yeah.
Yeah, that is on my list for sure this year too, because this house where we live now is really chilly in the mornings, and I'm the same way. I would rather that than a bathrobe, and I just end up in like hoodies, which I don't even feel like have the softness and the comfort that I want. Right.
And I do actually would really like a new, like a nice new hoodie too, because the ones I have are like, I swear they're like knockoffs for my kids. I don't even really know. I don't remember purchasing them. So John has a really nice one. I think it's called American Standard. Is that the brand?
Okay.
I mean, it's a deluxe hoodie. It is thick and warm. Let me look and actually make sure that's true before I – yep, I think it's called American Standard. So we'll link to that as well if you want something that goes beyond your – oh, no, sorry, American Giant.
Oh, okay.
American Standard, I think, is like faucets.
Okay.
So American Giant. Yes, they're very nice. So I may request one of those to show up under the tree. But one thing I will say is different for me from previous gift guides that we've done is that I think I'm no longer up for the Mukluks slippers.
You don't want them? You don't wear them anymore?
I want something else. And here's why. I still love the way they feel. They're still so awesomely warm and soft, and like they go, you know, halfway up your leg, and like this feels like having a little hug on your feet. But which I actually think maybe is Uggs like actually call themselves like a hug for your feet, or did someone just say that to me ironically once?
I don't know.
I might have just stolen their branding. But I find I'm kind of clumsy, and they're not structured enough.
Yeah.
So what's ending up happening is like if I'm carrying laundry up and down the stairs, I've been tripping myself while I'm wearing them, and that just can't happen because I'm already a klutz. So I want to go for something a little more structured. I might even just get a pair of soft boots.
Mm-hmm.
Ask for that and then wear those as slippers.
Yeah, I'm like, well, Uggs are like, I think of them as a California thing, even though we don't have super cold weather, but they're like, they started in surf culture in Australia, right? So like Uggs are everywhere here, like as cliche as it is, but I do feel like I kind of use my Uggs as half slippers, half cute outdoor, and it doesn't really work because they get too beat up. But then I'm also wearing them as slippers around the house when they're tracking in stuff. So I was actually thinking I need Mukluks. Like I need something that really is an indoor house slipper, and then wear my Uggs when I actually just want to wear them as my shoes for the day.
What about just getting a pair of knockoff Uggs?
Yeah. Yeah. No, that,
you know, you don't need them to hold up to the weather. So,
right.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's true too. Yeah. So something warm. And you know, I've gotten cheap slippers before. I actually asked for that this year. I like told my brother who I don't want to spend, you know, I don't want him to spend very much money. Like just regular department store or Target, like the slip-on kind, like mules, because I feel like I'm kicking them on and off if I'm going out to the garage or don't want to, you know, go outside. So I also like a pair of very inexpensive slip-on mule slippers. And that's a great, easy, very inexpensive gift because it doesn't, I don't care what pattern, what they look like or whatever.
Yeah, I don't either. Well, and that's the nice thing is you can always, if you're going to go the like knockoff boots thing, you know, you can go buy some ugly ones on clearance because why do you care? Right. You're just wearing them in the house. And I like the slip-on ones too. I think they're very practical. Gosh, I love the idea of having like something on my leg all the way up to the knee, but yeah, we'll see.
Yeah.
And also in the footwear vein, I do this year really want a pair of over-the-knee boots. And that is something – I mean, they're expensive.
Yeah.
The ones that go, like, up to your thighs.
Right.
And this might just not be that winter anyway.
Right.
But that would definitely be an example of a splurge. And I know Shayna and I talked about them on the Style Hour last year. She had a really specific recommendation. And then I actually found one on the Uggs website, too, that I like a lot.
Oh, nice.
So we can link to both of those. That's a splurgy kind of thing I'll never buy myself, but maybe to – you know, show up under the
right. Tree. I mean, you know, if you, when you've been eyeing it for like many months to over a year, it's like time to ask for the splurge or do the splurge. But I mean, we can kind of like sum that whole segment up as something cozy and warm for the house. And if you think about it, like whether you work outside the home or you spend a lot of time at home, it's nice to feel really warm and comfortable.
Yep.
And I think it is like kind of easy to lose sight of that. And you just get used to like your routine, but that's a great thing to put on your, so whatever you need, moms, yeah, to be more warm and comfortable around the house, that's a great thing to put on your list.
Well, and I don't remember if we talked about this in the last episode or last year when we were talking about house sweaters, but it's become like such a thing in our, like in our family culture where when, if we go over to, you know, my brother's house to hang out, we bring our house sweaters and slippers with us, and they do the same thing. Like they'll show up all decked out and like they'll be carrying their slippers.
I love it. So I love it.
We all just get into comfy mode like as fast as we can. It's a lot of fun.
That is great.
Another thing I have to throw out there that I never would have thought to purchase until I just saw a pair somewhere and bought them, but I love, are like thigh high socks.
Mm.
They are warm and comfy and practical. I mean, I like my leg warmery deals, but they're practical because it's just a sock. It's not like an extra thing that you have to buy and put on. So
That's why I wear UGGs, because we don't, we Californians don't
you
even
don't
own,
need to be that
I don't even own enough socks. All my socks are just for the gym. Otherwise, I wear.
Well, you're supposed to wear socks with UGGs, are you? Isn't
no,
that the whole point?
But that's why I don't, because if my feet are cold, I just wear UGGs. Right. So I don't really need socks. Right. I got a very nice pair of leather flat boots, like everyday boots, last year, and I do wear socks with those. But yes, we are in different lands in that regard. So I wanted to kind of move on to another area, and that is, last year you picked out the cutest personalized notebook journal thing from minted.com, and you put it on our gift guide. But that just brings up the whole category of like, you know, office or stationery products or really nice pens, journals, that whole thing. And I feel like there's very few people who don't love that kind of stuff.
I was just going to say, like, I don't feel like you could ever go wrong with a really nice journal, great pens. I love packages of Sharpies, like the thin ones and the different colors.
Well, you've gotten me into writing, using fine point Sharpies as regular pens. I really, I don't know. I'm like self-deprivation or something. I really only used them for like certain types of paper or certain things, but now I'm starting to use them for everyday stuff, and they're like so nice to write with.
And I just like to use different colors. My life, Sharpies. You know, my to-do list, my notebook that has my to-do list in it, like one day it's purple, one day it's, you know, navy blue, one day it's kind of like a dusky rose. I mean, I just like switch on and off whatever mood I'm in. I don't know. It's, we all need like one little thing to perk ourselves up, right? So if it's writing in a, your to-do list in purple, Sharpie.
Or on a really nice like cardstock paper. I mean, it just feels different to write on nice paper. So Minted is great for those kind of things. We've linked to them before and we can. Do you have any other favorite paper lines or places to get that kind of stuff?
I feel like I mean, this isn't stationary, but did our sponsor from earlier the year, Kristen Shop, did she have some stationary type stuff in her store?
Yeah, she does. Hers are mostly like to-do list type stuff, but she has some very cute journals and that kind of stuff. So we will link to her shop for sure. That's Kristen Shop.
The caveat I would give, if you're, you know, a husband type person listening in, if your spousal person loves stationery and likes making to-do lists, then that's a great gift. If they're not, maybe not the route you want to take.
Right. Especially if it's very specific, like to-do list paper.
Like, exactly, to-do list paper.
And when I buy cards, like stationery as a gift, I also like to do kind of as generic as possible. So it could be a thank you note. It could be, and I love having that kind of stationery around, just like small cards that you could use for any occasion. I mean, it's nice to have real thank you cards or specific holidays or whatever, but I feel like generic goes a long way, and it's great to have that kind of stuff around the house.
Another one that's like maybe a slightly like maybe easier to find or and the price point's really good is the Martha Stewart line at Staples.
Okay, I knew the Staples one that you'd mentioned before.
She has like really fun little notebooks. I mean, they're not fancy like the ones at Minted. They're more, I guess they just look a little more practical, but I really like them, and they come in different colors, and there's coordinating, all kinds of coordinating stuff. So if you're shopping for someone who's really into organizing or office supplies, you really can't go wrong with a bunch of coordinated stuff, I think.
Makes it
look, put it all together in a package and voila, you've got a gift.
Right. I love that. Okay, so I'm just looking down at our list from last year. Now, we put the America's Test Kitchen family cookbook on there last year. And what we wrote about it was that having like a great classic cookbook, no matter what kind of cook you are, how much, you know, fancy stuff you do, that having one of those great resource cookbooks like Joy of Cooking or Better Homes, you know, all those is really useful. So again, I think that's tricky territory to buy someone a cookbook if they're not super into cooking. But do you like getting cookbooks as gifts? Have you gotten any of those types?
I do. I like getting, I love getting a really beautiful cookbook mm-hmm. as a gift. I want to say it's called The Homemade Kitchen. My guest recently Alana. On the home. Yeah, mm-hmm. Alana Ternilla. Her book is gorgeous. I got a free copy from their publisher. But if I had gotten that, you know, under the tree, mm-hmm. that would have made me very happy. It's gorgeous to look at. It's got great recipes. It's just one of those things that feels like an indulgence.
Yes.
My Joy of Cooking cookbook was a gift 20 years ago. Yes. And I still use it all the time. And it's one of those things I like having in the kitchen. So I think you're right. Like, I think if it's, you know, 30 budget meals under $5. Maybe that's right. not so exciting, but if it's something that looks like it feels like a gift, you know,
yeah. And I think if you don't have, if you've been wanting to have like a really good basic one and you don't, you want to put it on your Christmas list. I'm a huge fan of the America's Test Kitchen. The whole line of them, but it's the family cookbook is the one that we have. So again, maybe not something that a spouse would surprise you with if you didn't want it, but if that's something you really want to give a hint, that particular one is so great, I think.
Another
idea.
We
usually sell it at Costco and Target and stuff.
Another idea might be a subscription to Cooks Illustrated.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
That's such a unique magazine. All the pictures are illustrations, which is really cool. Like it's very different. It's very unique and cool. And sometimes I think subscriptions are fun. You know?
Subscriptions are really fun. That one, when you subscribe to that magazine, you also have access to their like online library, which is really, really detailed. And I know because once our subscription ended, we were trying to get in there and we could not. So it is subscription protected recipes and techniques and videos all from that whole, you know, America's Test Kitchen Cooks Illustrated brand. And it's really, really great. So...
Well, bonus. While we're on that topic, let's talk about subscriptions.
Yes.
Have you done any of like the Birchbox or any of those?
I got one for Brian last year, actually, for the men's side, like a 3-month or maybe 2 years ago from Birchbox. So, yeah. And he liked it. It wasn't where I find them very expensive. They can be very expensive. So I got him, I think, a 3-month one, and it was different. I think it was both products like aftershave and lotions, but there was also like socks and a few other fashion, like smaller fashion things, not right. full outfits. He has also done the Trunk Club, which is like the really high end one for men's wear. So ironically in our house, it's the husband who has done subscription fashion and beauty.
Well, I mean,
I haven't gotten any myself. Have you?
I have not. Brian does seem like that kind of guy to me. Yes. I don't know him that well. But he's a little metro. It's, you know, he and John have that in common. I think John always has nicer toiletries than I do. Always. And it's, but I can't blame him because I pick my stuff out, generally speaking, and he picks out his, you know, mm-hmm. or he might get me for Christmas, like a really nice lotion or something like that. But it's stuff that tends to run out. Pretty quickly. And so when I look in his little beautiful leather, by the way, shaving kit that is way better than the free knockoff Clinique bag I've been carrying around for, or not even a knockoff, but it's just a free with purchase.
Right. Yes.
Clinique cosmetic bag. I think I've had the same one for 12 years now. That's probably awesome. Time to upgrade. But his stuff is really, really nice. And so I'm like, oh, but I feel like something like a Birchbox. The thing is, I love cosmetics. I love playing with them. Mm-hmm. I just don't really go to Sephora or Ulta that often. And when I do go, I feel like I'm in a hurry. So when I get overwhelmed, I don't know the brands as well as I used to. You know, like 20 years ago, I knew all the brands. I would know and I'd go in and be like, oh, you know, that's a good brand or that's I heard about that product. Right. And I'm sort of removed from that right now. So the what appeals to me about Birchbox and things like that is I don't have to think about it.
Right. Yeah, that
shows
true.
Up and I don't, you know, I don't have to pick. It's like it's picked for me. I think as an indulgence, that's kind of fun.
Very, very much. And related to that, I just had an idea is that another great gift would be going to have your makeup done or have a trial session with a stylist. Okay. Like if you're, because sometimes the problem is like we've been not reading 17 magazine for 20 years.
We don't even
like,
know what's out
don't
there.
No, like you're the episode you did about makeup.
Yeah.
with, Shayna's sister on the Style Hour was like, we have to like relearn all this.
I know. There's just so much product.
That was actually a really cool gift is just like a department store makeup trial, where they do it for you or, you know, all those places. Because sometimes it's just the technique that we need help with.
And I have to say, I don't know how I keep getting subscribed to all these magazines. And I was kind of laughing about it because they're all magazines I haven't read in 10 years or longer.
Right.
All of a sudden, like, Shape started showing up at my door and I'm getting In Style now. I have, it must be something else I'm buying and it's tacking on a subscription.
Okay. Didn't you figure out it was Fabletics?
I think it might be, but I'm not 100% sure. So, and I do order from there a lot. So that would actually make a lot of sense. But, you know, I have to say, like, the first time I got In Style, I thought, this is like something I might read while getting a pedicure, but I just don't really read magazines like this. Right. But I did sit down and flip through the cosmetics section, and it was kind of fun, like, getting back in touch with that sort of girlier side, that my youthful girly side that I really haven't delved in. And I used to love that stuff. I used to love knowing all the newest products and what they did and all that stuff. So
I did too. And I used to be really darn good at eye makeup, like when I was performing on stage and like reading all the magazines. And like, we had a fancy party this weekend and I was like, yeah, I mean, I don't know how to do it like 1997 style, but I'm pretty sure.
Right.
That's not
it anymore.
Yeah.
So I think a magazine subscription like that could also be a fun thing. Like,
yes,
it's a fun thing that you wouldn't really usually subscribe to yourself, probably. And so something like that can also be a lot of fun.
Agreed. That's a great idea. We touched on this one in our Thanksgiving episode, but you love aprons, and an apron is actually on my Christmas list this year. Mom, are you listening? I think my mom is getting me an apron because she was here and noticed we don't have any. And then actually the kids need aprons because we cook a lot, and we talked about this a few episodes ago. I need like the full coverage model,
right?
Not the waist one. Yes,
it's waisted.
So we will link to a few. We'll just find a few cute ones. But that's one I feel like it doesn't have to be a perfect style because it's an apron. Like, it doesn't have to be like an outfit that you'd wear out. So if it's a spouse or a sister or a mom, it's just, you can be a little freer with choosing a cute pattern and not worrying that you're not going to like it or it needs to be exactly your style. So
I absolutely agree. That'd be a great gift. And I do feel like maybe an apron might be one of those gifts, depending on your romantic relationship, partnership, whatever status, might be better received from a mom or a friend or a sister.
True.
I don't know. Hard to say in your house. Like, if John got me an apron and it was really cute, I'd be very happy. But he knows I already wear them and I like them. If you know, someone right now is listening and your significant other is sketchy on how they feel about the kitchen.
Right. It could be. Well, it's like in Father
it's
the Bride,
loaded.
She gets the blender, right?
Right. It could be loaded. So just as a caveat.
Yeah. But that is actually on my list this year. And there are, it's just, I think, a fun one to like go crazy and choose a funky pattern or whatever.
Well, Megan, I've been wearing Vionic shoes for over 3 years now, but this month, my trusted shoe brand and I entered a new phase of our relationship, international travel.
Well, Sarah, that is a serious commitment.
Right? You can't just pack any shoe for a trip abroad. It's got to be stylish enough for those major cosmopolitan cities. It's got to be sturdy enough for trains, planes, buses, and city streets. And obviously, it's got to be comfortable enough to support your feet over many, many miles of walking. Well, no surprise, my Vionics were up to the task. I had two pair with me, a pair of casual sneakers in a cool gray color, and then a weatherproof suede ankle boot that I swear still looks brand new after 10 days on soggy sidewalks. Megan, the only time my feet hurt the entire trip was New Year's Eve when I made the mistake of wearing a pair of booties not from Vionic. So I'll just leave that data right here for you.
Okay, well, that's pretty conclusive, Sarah. Vionic has the best curated styles to get you ready for whatever 2024 has in store, whether it's jet setting like Sarah or keeping up with busy mom life on this side of the pond. They even offer a 30-day guarantee. Wear them, love them, or return them for a full refund within 30 days. And we've got a great deal for you. Use code THEMOMHOUR15 at checkout for 15% off your entire order at vionicshoes.com when you log into your account. That's a one-time use only. Vionic shoes, wearable well-being for your feet. Sarah, when my kids were little, I was always pretty torn on whether to give them a daily multivitamin. I knew that modern kids' diets have some pretty big nutritional gaps, but I also knew that most children's vitamins are basically candy in disguise. They're filled with sugar, they have all kinds of chemicals and preservatives in them, and I was like, why would I give these to my kids? Luckily, two dads recognized the problem and came up with a solution. Hiya, the pediatrician-approved, super-powered, chewable vitamin.
Hiya fills in the most common gaps in modern children's diets to provide the full body nourishment our kids need with a yummy taste they love. Formulated with the help of nutritional experts, Hiya is pressed with a blend of 12 organic fruits and veggies, then supercharged with 15 essential vitamins and minerals, including vitamin D, B12, C, zinc, folate, and many others to help support immunity, energy, brain function, mood, concentration, teeth, bones, and more. Your first shipment comes with a cute bottle that has fun stickers your kids can use to decorate it too. My kids always loved that.
And we've worked out a special deal with Hiya for their best-selling children's vitamin. Receive 50% off your first order. To claim this deal, go to hiyahealth.com/momhour. This deal is not available on their regular website. Go to hiyahealth.com/momhour and get your kids the full body nourishment they need to grow into healthy adults.
Now, I will say, as far as like kitchen equipment goes, I don't know anyone, any mom or woman, who would be offended by, say, like a KitchenAid stand mixer. Right. Just throwing that out there, because they're beautiful, and you don't have it. Doesn't say anything about your relationship to the kitchen, really. It's just like this is beautiful thing that's going to stand in your kitchen, and once in a while, you might want to make some cookies.
Right.
So I kind of feel like stuff like that, you almost can't go wrong, if it's that like a little bit higher end.
Yeah.
You know, beautiful to look at, well-designed, brand everyone knows, blah, blah, blah. People get excited about that stuff.
Yeah.
I think no matter how they feel about cooking. So
I would agree. And another one, if you entertain or would like to entertain more, that I would love is just assorted serving pieces, not anything from a match set or a registry, but a beautiful bowl that could be used for serving. And there is some personal style in that, but if you go pretty classic and really nice quality, that's another one where it will always be used, and you don't tend to buy that stuff for yourself. You don't even realize you want it until you realize you don't, you know, you're serving things and don't have enough. So that could be fun. All those things too, the aprons, and are fun to do in local shops and local boutiques or Etsy if you're into that. So, you know, just kind of one of a kind pieces.
Agreed. And, you know, we talked a little bit earlier, I mean, this is kind of getting away from the kitchen thing, but back toward the local shops. We talked about like fashionable or fashionable, whichever one it is. If you have any kind of a free trade store near you, which a lot of, even in our little town now, we have one, you can buy a lot of that stuff, maybe not that particular brand, but a lot of those responsibly sourced products locally. And those are really fun. I think it's kind of unique. Often they package really beautifully, and they might have a little card that tells you about the organization and all that kind of thing as well. So I like to troll those places as well.
I think that's great. And the older we get, I think we kind of just feel like the source is, you know, that has meaning.
Right.
You know, it is less about the stuff than it was years ago. It's kind of part of the whole bigger picture.
Yep.
So last year we talked in our post a little bit about wall art, which obviously is a very personal choice, but you had some great ideas about art.com, a gift certificate to art.com or to a framing store, or to take if you do have a favorite print, to have it framed, basically just to sort of like help get something up on
take
the wall.
Take the work out of the getting the, take the work out of it.
Exactly. Because that's something where we all get stuck, whether it's framing a bunch of family photos or a favorite piece, or a gift certificate to a framing store. Framing is expensive, but it can make a big difference on your wall.
And honestly, I've had the experience where I've gone to Michael's or Joann's or another store that has frames and have not been able to find the size frame and matting I need to get a picture up, and it just never goes up. It's like I'm only going to work so hard, you know?
Right.
And so I have pictures that I really want to hang that aren't. So I always feel like it's so expensive to have to order it framed when you buy art, or to have something framed. But really, if it buys you back that much time, especially if you're giving it as a gift to a busy mom who wants that picture on the wall but just isn't really able to you know, get the equipment or put the time in herself right now, that's a really good gift.
I agree. And here's something I will say about giving artwork or wall stuff is, when I have received it as a gift, a couple of times, I think from family members, I personally don't even care if it's not really my perfect style. I love getting, one time my brother found like this sketch of a child in an antique store. It was already framed. And it was like thrift store, and I still have it. I love it. So sometimes, I mean, it may not be like the centerpiece above your mantle, but because shopping for art can be overwhelming and expensive, sometimes just getting something just because, you know, somebody picked it out for you or it comes from a particular place. We have another painting that's from like Argentina when my parents went there. So if you're a spouse or a family member and you're a little skittish about giving that kind of stuff because it might not match, I think it's almost worth the risk sometimes because it's really fun to receive original art, even a small print.
I'll take it a step further and say sometimes I think it's preferable because especially if the person that you're buying it for isn't really confident in their tastes of, you know, art, which a lot of us, I'm going to just say me. It kind of is nice to get the nod of approval from someone else. Like, I thought this was worth purchasing to give to you because I thought you would like it. It's like, oh, it kind of boosts your confidence in putting it up, in my opinion. So yeah,
and it has a story behind it.
Yeah. Yep. Agreed.
Agreed. All right. Well, has anything come up for you since we've started talking? I don't want to leave out major categories here.
One thing I was actually going to say is that something I don't think we had ever put on any of these categories before, but something that I feel like is definitely a good investment is a good pair of earbuds or a wireless headset. And John got me a wireless headset like 2 years ago, and I never used it because I thought, what's the big deal? I already have my Beats by Dre, which I really love. Why do I need this wireless thing? It looks complicated. You know, you have to plug it, like you have to Bluetooth it to your phone. It just seemed really complicated. I know it's not, but it just seemed complicated.
Right.
And then I started using it, and oh my gosh, it's like at the gym. You know, when you're at the gym and you really want to listen to your music, but you also want to like, I don't know, lift hand weights at the same time, but you can't.
Yeah, you don't have pockets.
Right, like
put it in your sports bra.
Exactly.
Oh, I did that today.
Or you go for a walk and you've got your phone attached to your head and where are you going to put your phone? And I don't like those things where you strap them to your arm. I feel like those feel weird. So anyway, I started using my wireless thing and I love it. So the one I have, I will recommend. I can't even remember what it's called right now. I will recommend, or I will link to it in the show notes.
I love that idea.
It's great. It's an LG. That's all I know about
it.
It's an LG. It looks kind
of
cool.
And then that reminded me of one gift that was a little stocking stuffer Brian got me a few years ago, but along the same lines it's just a charging cradle for the iPhone. But the way that the iPhone sits in it, and we have it up in our kitchen, just almost on the windowsill, so it's away. But just a dock, it's a very small little dock for an iPhone, but just having a place to put the phone that's not dangling on a cord that's then trailing out on the counter that you're yanking in and out 10 times a day. It looks cleaner and it's like somewhere that I always know where my phone is if I've just, you know, put it there. And that one's a Belkin brand, Belkin. And that it's great. And it looks really streamlined on the counter when most of our counters are like a mess of charging cords. Yeah. So that's another just little idea that was a great gift.
Well, and along those lines, if you're listening to podcasts and you still are listening off of your phone or
in a cereal bowl,
or if you are listening from your laptop or whatever, we have a kitchen speaker that's a Bose, and then we have another one that's called, I think it's called a Boom. And it just makes it so nice. If you have a party, it's funny because I actually was carrying our Bose around like to other people's houses for a while until they finally were all like, all right, we'll get our own.
We have Sonos and we take the small ones. We move them from room to room. Like if we're, you know, if we're outside.
For listening to music. Now we listen to more music together as a family because everyone can hear it. You know, we can put it in different areas of the house. If you get two that are the same, you can make them work in stereo together sometimes, which is cool.
Nice.
So we can link to a few of those. I think maybe we've written about that in the past. I think it's totally worth the investment if you are getting into listen. If you just want to listen to more music.
Yep.
We've talked about how sometimes when your mom listening to music kind of falls off of your radar or listening
you just
to current
forget
music. You forget. And I think also and listening to podcasts, it just makes it a lot easier.
Yes, I love all of those ideas. We'll definitely link. I did also see our friends at Cool Mom Picks, who have the sister site Cool Mom Tech. They came out with their gift guide today, and I love their technology picks. So we'll link to that too, because if it's technology related, and it is sometimes fun to get that stuff as a gift because it can be overwhelming to shop for, and it can make life just a little easier, better.
This kind of has to do with technology, and it also has to do with subscriptions. I also think a Spotify subscription, like a paid subscription, would be a great gift.
Yes. You know,
Mom in Your Life doesn't already have it. It makes it really easy to share music with your friends and find out what people are listening to. And it does it. I don't know if you ever listened to yours, Sarah, but it does that cool thing where weekly it puts together like a custom playlist for you.
Yeah, I haven't. I just see my face on it because it has your right. profile.
And I'll listen to it. And, you know, sometimes it's not.
Right.
It's off, way off.
Right.
But there's been plenty of times I've discovered a new song via that list. And cool. I've been like, oh, this is for me. So something like that. I think you just can't go wrong with something that makes it really easy for a mom in your life to just do the stuff that she would want to do anyway.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, the wheels are turning. I'm getting Brian, who can't listen to this episode now, but an Audible subscription. Mm-hmm. We're going to get our family that for Christmas, basically, because for audiobooks, because he drives all the time and has listened to a couple audiobooks. And the library does have them, and there are some free through Amazon Prime, but not really, I think, to the degree that he's looking for. So
right.
Spotify, Audible, Amazon Prime, I mean, like, if you don't have Amazon Prime and you want to put that action on your Christmas list.
Absolutely.
Right now.
Right now.
Yeah, so any of those agreed would make great gifts. So I'm curious, I'm going to switch gears a little bit.
Yeah,
I'm curious
ahead.
How, like, do you drop hints? Like, say you think of something that you would like, do you drop hints to John? Is John just really good at picking up on this kind of
thing? I feel like I'm the worst person to ask about this because I don't really drop hints, and he always seems to know something that I would like to get me. And I also, I like the surprise of having absolutely no idea what's under the tree. And mm-hmm. usually he'll get me great stuff that I really didn't ask for. And sometimes I didn't even hint around for, but it's still great. But
right.
I don't feel like most dads are necessarily that adept at gift giving
right.
from what I've heard from my friends.
Right.
So I think dropping really good hints. I think one thing I was doing for a while is I would go shopping with my brother when mm-hmm. he was buying for Jenna. And
oh, yeah.
I think it's always nice to have somebody who really knows that person well, who maybe
yeah.
has heard about stuff they want.
Yeah.
You know, if you're the partner listening mm-hmm. And you just are clueless, you know, take her mom shopping.
Yeah.
Or take her
yeah.
sister, her best friend
yeah.
and ask and have them help you a little bit. Or send an email. I mean,
yeah.
you know, Sarah, if John emailed you and said, I'm stuck, I need help. I mean,
right.
I could come up with 10 things that you
right.
would like.
Right.
So,
right.
or that you could come up with 10 things I would
yeah.
like. So,
yeah.
yeah.
No, I like that idea. I like that idea. We are this, I mean, Brian is really pretty good about it too. I do drop hints and I am less, I don't like surprises. I mean, I'm fine about.
We've already established that you hate
yeah.
fun, Sarah.
I know.
So
surprises falls under that. I'm fine about being surprised of things under the Christmas tree, but I am more the type to drop a hint if I see something specific.
Right.
Also because, like, I'm always draw a blank when people ask. So if I see something, I kind of want to, you know, drop the hint before I forget about it,
yeah.
so to speak. But what about the kids? Do the kids shop for you or make you stuff?
We do things differently every year. They always make us stuff in school, and
mm-hmm.
so that's always fun, like unwrapping that. And then usually what we'll end up doing is, like, dividing the kids up into teams and sending them shopping.
That's good.
Together. So, like, maybe each team gets the person that they're shopping for. So maybe
right.
like the Jacob Clara team gets
yeah.
John, and, you know, the
yeah.
other three get John or me or whatever. I mean, we mix it up every year. So that's kind of all over the place. And, you know, one thing it's that I kind of wish I had done differently. And if you're listening and your kids are still young, maybe it's just something to think about, is that we really didn't create a culture of the bigger kids as they got older, taking
mm-hmm.
more responsibility for the gift giving for
mm-hmm.
me and John. And I mean, it's like I don't really care. It's not like I need
right.
more stuff, but I feel like it would be good for them too, to just get more practice in
right.
like doing the whole thing themselves, not
yeah,
just
and budgeting
getting dropped
and
off at a store, but
right.
you know, so that's something I think we'll do a little more intentionally this year. I say
yeah.
10 days from Christmas.
Well, this is the first year that I, I've always bought, you know, a few things for Brian and then just literally labeled, oh, this one's from Allegro. This one's from the baby, you know,
yeah.
but really they had nothing to do with it. So this year, I guess this is a little off topic, but since we've gone here, so this year I took turns taking the older two kids to shop for their two siblings and Brian. And I took them to Walgreens of all places because I figured it was less overwhelming than Target because
mm-hmm.
Target is so big and the price ranges for everything
all over the place,
go all
yeah.
the way up, and they're going to see so many things that they want for themselves, which it's hard when you're only, especially five, to keep in mind that you're shopping for somebody else. And I thought Walgreens is perfect. It has a little toy aisle. They can shop for their siblings. Right. It has just doodads and everything. And it was the perfect place to go because it just wasn't like a toy store where they were going to get all goggly eyed about everything they wanted for themselves. And it was great. They didn't have to spend their own money because they don't get an allowance yet. So I just said between $10 and $20, one thing for each of your siblings and one thing for dad. And they both, I did it separately so they could do it for each other. And they both loved it. So that was, I think we will continue to do that. And I know Brian has been behind the scenes with them about my gifts. So I think as they get older, it is fun to include them in that. And then if they do get an allowance or have a job, I don't remember how that worked growing up, but I do remember spending my own money on family Christmas gifts. Although it may have been that we were given kind of like a little allowance budget. You know what I mean? Right. Like it was, we were helped with it, but it was to a certain point. So here's $100 shop for everyone in the family or something. Yeah. I think for me,
I always had a job from the time I was like in 10th grade on. And I just remember at some point wanting to buy my parents gifts. I don't remember when it happened or how it was is now something I'm going to do as well. So, it's funny. And you mentioned Walgreens. I think that's perfect. Like keeping it on a smaller scale. And it reminded me that when the kids were littler, like when all of them were under, say 12, we used to go to the dollar store or to Five Below, which is like, I don't know if you have those, but
no.
It's like the dollar store, except everyone's $5 or less. And then they would have, they'd each have somebody that they were shopping for. Sometimes it'd be all of their siblings the thing is a dollar store. It's going to be junk. Right. But for them, it made it easier for them to pick something out because everything costs the same amount. Like at the dollar store, everything is a dollar. So they knew exactly what they could get. Right. And sometimes I'd be like, well, you can get two or three things if you need to group them together or whatever, but here's your budget. And that was fun. And it's not like the awesome toy of the month was there anyway, that was going to get them coveting it. So that's more for the experience of gift giving. You're not going to get anything awesome, but I think that's a valuable thing.
I think so too. And I think even if they're not ready to like have their own money, even if they're spending your money, just the practice of picking it out, knowing what the spending limit is, all of those are good things. Oh, so
did we cover all of the ground?
I think so. Have you thought of anything else during this that you really want for Christmas?
No, but now I can go back and listen to this and I'll be reminded of all the things that I want that I didn't even remember that I wanted. And,
I know. So. I want a house sweater and an apron and I wouldn't cry at new Uggs. So I'm pretty clear from this podcast.
Yeah. Wouldn't cry at new Uggs. Maybe that should be the title of the podcast. Well, I
wouldn't be mad if there were Uggs under the
Christmas. Know that last year, I got John two pairs of Uggs for Christmas. Two pair of Uggs.
I too.
So, well, because I wanted him to have fancy Uggs. So the Uggs they picked out were the ones that he really wanted, or he picked them out. I mean, I knew which ones he liked. It wasn't like he sent me a link, but they were just like your typical Uggs. And he does a lot of client work where he needs to have something warm on his feet, but I don't want him shuffling around these doctor's offices in big puffy Uggs. I don't know why. So I got him a fancy pair of Uggs, which are look more like a more structured, like, black leather boot.
Okay.
So you could wear them. They're just dressier. They're still Uggy on the inside. They still feel like Uggs, but they just look like you could wear them out to a nice bar or whatever. I mean, it's just totally different look. So he got two pairs because I couldn't decide which ones I wanted to have. Now he has worn the fluffy, sloppy Uggs a lot more than the other ones, but the other ones definitely do come in handy sometimes and he'll have them for years. I mean, they're great boots and they're never going to go out of style. They're just a really classic look. So.
Right.
So I got zero Uggs, so maybe it's my turn this year.
It is your turn. Yep. It is the year of the Uggs. okay, well, we will definitely link to all of these things in the show notes, which are at themomhour.com. This is episode, 32. This is airing December 15th, so you guys have 10 days, probably 8 or 9 days, 7 if you're using Amazon Prime shipping.
Exactly.
To drop these hints and let us know, send us an email or let us know in the comments what you want for Christmas.
We want to know.
All right, everybody.
Email us at hello@themomhour.com.
Yes, we love to hear from you. Megan, do you want to let people know again what we're planning to do for Christmas week in terms of podcast?
Starting next week, we will be doing, I don't know, we haven't really quite figured out yet if it's going to be 5 or 6 little mini episodes, but you know,
one a day in theory.
One a day in theory could start as early as Sunday, or it could, you know, end on Saturday. I don't know. We're just playing it by ear right now. But we're going to be reading our favorite holiday themed essays and blog posts that we've written over the years. So it's going to be, they're going to be quickie episodes. You're going to be in the kitchen cooking or wrapping gifts or whatever. And maybe you don't have time to sit and listen 50 minutes of us rambling on, but you might have 10 minutes. And so we're just going to kind of just do something a little bit different and read our favorite stuff, which I'm excited to kind of dust some of those pieces off because we've written a lot about the holidays.
Yeah. And it's fun. I have listened to a couple of read aloud type podcasts and it is fun. It's different. It's different to read something aloud that's been written. It's kind of a different form. It'll be fun. Yeah.
So it'll be fun. And then we'll probably take a break, right? Like a week off?
Yeah.
And then come back after the
week
holidays.
In between Christmas and New Year's. And then come back on that week of the 3rd of January. Ah, cannot believe that.
I know.
We're already there.
I know. Well, this has been fun. I hope everyone gets something that makes them happy.
Yes.
This holiday.
Or a gift card. Or a gift receipt to turn it back in.
Whatever makes you happy, or if you have to make yourself happy with someone else's money, that's
I love it. All right, everybody. Happy holidays. We'll talk to you soon.
The Mom Hour is brought to you by partners like The Essential Calendar. The Essential Calendar makes beautiful, minimalist, poster-sized calendars that show an entire season at a glance so you can see and plan for the big picture. If you're looking ahead to 2024 and have big plans you want to see all in one place, visit theessentialcalendar.com/themomhour. You'll save 10% off your purchase when you visit that link or use code THEMOMHOUR at checkout. Again, that's 10% off our favorite seasonal calendars at theessentialcalendar.com/themomhour. Hi, friends. Megan here. I wanted to let you know about a new podcast I've just launched called The Teas Made. Think of it as a weekly cozy conversation with me over your favorite hot beverage on topics like wellness, creativity, family, hospitality, and more. Just look for The Teas Made with Megan Francis wherever you get your podcasts or head to theteasmade.com to find all those episodes. The Teas Made is your reminder to take a little break from the busyness of life. So come on in and get comfy. The Teas Made.